Watch any programming or Unity tutorial and you'll pretty soon start hearing the word instance being used all over the place. It's a critical concept to understand, but can be a bit confusing to wrap your head around when you first start out. An instance is an example or single occurrence of something. In programming, we often talk about instances in the context of classes. However, you will also hear people talking about instances of arrays, delegates, structs, and other entities. For now, let's focus on classes. When we talk about instances, we're essentially making the distinction between the word the and the word a. Using the suggests what we're talking about is singular. The boat, the plane, the car. Whereas when we use the word a, we're talking about one of many occurrences, or in this case, one of many instances. A boat, a plane, a car. The boat, the plane, or the car is a concept. A boat, a plane, or a car is an instance, or occurrence of that concept. In programming, the concept of our boat, plane, or car is represented using a class, and we can create instances of this class to have many boats, planes, and cars. Where this can cause some confusion in Unity is the different ways that we can create our instances. In your game, you're going to need instances of your objects that players interact with. For example, creating an empty game object in the hierarchy and slapping a script onto it is one way of getting an instance of this class into your game. But we have to do this before the game starts. If we want to create new instances of our objects while the game is running, we can use the instantiate function that Unity provides as part of its API. Instantiate creates a new object in the scene while the game is being played. We can call this instantiate function in our code, but we need a reference to an existing game object so that we can duplicate it and add it to our scene. Often, we use a prefab as the reference, which is just a save of the game object we previously configured for use later. So what we do is create an empty game object in our hierarchy, put a script on it that controls the object's functionality, and then drag this object into our project window. This converts our object into a prefab, which we can use as a reference in our instantiate function. Alternatively, you can also reference the game object without converting it into a prefab. For example, by just dragging the existing object into the field you're referencing in the instantiate function. So we can create instances of our objects in Unity by creating a game object directly in our hierarchy, or by calling the instantiate function in our code to spawn a clone of an object we have a reference to. Not too shabby. The final point I want to make about instances is regarding the new keyword in C#. When I first started out, the use of the new keyword really confused me. It isn't immediately obvious when or why we need to use new in C#. For example, if I create an instance of an int to store a specific number in my code, I don't need to use the new keyword. But if I want to create an instance of a class, say an instance of my boat, to reference something contained in that class, I need to use the new keyword. Or if I want to create a list or an array to store some numbers in, I need to use the new keyword here. Additionally, if you spent any time in Unity, you'll probably be familiar with vectors, and when we create a vector2 in our code, we often use the new keyword. So why do we use the new keyword in some places and not in others? The reason relates to the concept of types in C#. We generally work with two types of data, value types and reference types. Ints, floats, and bools are all examples of value types because variables of these types contain their data, or in other words, contain their value directly. On the other hand, classes that we create, as well as objects and arrays, are all reference types because they store references to their data. You can think of reference types as pointing to some data rather than owning it directly. Don't worry about understanding the difference in detail for now. All you need to understand is that there are two different types in C#. Value types and reference types. If we want to create a new instance of a reference type, such as classes, arrays, objects, etc., we must initialize them using the new keyword. Because by default, reference types are null, so if we don't use the new keyword and try to reference the variable, we will get a null reference exception. In the case of lists, these are a class, and because classes are reference types, they are null by default until we initialize them with the new keyword. Conversely, value types like ints and bools don't need to be initialized with new because they can't actually be null. Instead, if you don't assign anything to the variable, they will just be the default value, which in the case of an int is 0, and in the case of a bool is false. So whenever you see the new keyword being used, it's usually because a variable is being created of a reference type which needs to be initialized so we don't get a null reference when trying to access this variable. There are some exceptions to this, for example in the case of vectors. A vector 2 or vector 3 is actually what's known as a struct, which is similar to a class, but unlike a class which is a reference type, structs are value types, which means they contain their own data directly instead of pointing to it. For now, you probably don't need to know too much about structs, but the reason we often use new when creating a variable of type vector 2 is because we want to initialize the vector with specific coordinates instead of the default ones. You can actually create a variable of type vector 2 in the same way as you would with an int and just leave it unassigned. This will result in a vector with x and y coordinates of 0, 0. Notice that if vectors were reference types like classes, objects, and arrays, trying to reference this vector would give us a null value. But because vectors are a struct, which is a value type that holds its data directly, the variable is initialized to its default value of 0, 0. Just like an int is initialized to its default value of 0 when we create a new instance of it and don't assign any specific number. So when we use the new keyword, we're essentially creating an instance of a vector with the coordinates we're passing in. Hopefully that's cleared up what instances are, how they're created, and when the new keyword needs to be used to initialize variables. If this is your first time hearing about value types and reference types, don't worry if you don't fully grasp the concept. You can check out the description for a link to a more detailed explanation of them.